So
thinking now, thinking about how am I thinking, you know?
It's not really linear or sporadic, or it's just whatever that works actually, yes.
First of all, I never hang on to one thought for too long. And it's more of a, I'm gonna call it clutter.
My roommate, I think, nailed it on the head when he said I have a Jenga mind. So have you ever played the game Jenga? You know, you have that one tower and you're taking pieces away, or you're putting pieces there to make something stand. And that's very much the way my mind works, because I don't really think linearly. When I'm working on a piece, I'll start in the beginning, I'll start at the end, do a little bit of the middle, then go back to the end. And
I feel like my thinking is almost like a pattern. It's not very linear.
When I'm creating, I try to keep an empty mind so that I don't get confused, and then I don't worry about like what color am I gonna use, where am I gonna place something.
If I could change my thinking?
At this point, I feel comfortable because I know even if I feel like I'm in trouble because I don't have a structure or I'm lost, or I know that I'll get to a point where it'll all come together.
I just wish I was less lazy.
Then it all comes down to the same thing. It's who we are and what we do.
No, I don't think my ideas are ever complete.
I think that an idea, like in terms of my creative process, an idea would be a complete piece. So when I finish a dance, then I think that that's complete.
Thinking about the show, the last gallery show I did, and I completed the idea, but now I'm testing it further.
I think once, maybe twice, have I sat down to write a poem and it's more or less complete.
You know, they're not finished until you say I'm done. I'm not thinking about this anymore.
I could stop an idea from growing. And I say, okay, I'm gonna do this and just let it be, rather than just dwelling on it and, you know.
I'm able to bring these ideas down to earth, put them together, package them, if you will, and then see them to fruition.
My ideas can turn into a performance that may be complete in that you know, point in time, but what's great about being, you know, a human and interacting with millions of people in this world is that you can hear a new idea or a new take on that idea that can completely shatter what you originally thought.
You gotta wait for the closure, but it comes eventually. Everything, I think, everything inspires me.
I find a lot of inspiration in nature.
I could look anywhere and find something interesting.
I find that whenever I go see dance, like just other shows, and see what other people are doing, it just triggers so many more things in my mind.
When I see people do things that are not controlled by fear and that involve overcoming fear, that's what makes me want to be a great person and a great artist.
When I'm observing other people and interactions with other people, I myself get inspiration.
When I hit a mental wall, what do I do?
I usually just like distract myself, like I'll like go to bed.
I don't like those moments.
You know, if I'm in a rehearsal process and it's not working for me, like trying like to improvise or something, I like take some time and like even not in a studio, just by myself, to kind of think through like different ideas and what would really work.
Whatever that happens, I just keep on struggling, keep on getting stressed.
If I hit a music mental wall, I'll go paint. If I'm, you know, or I'll design something.
You'll have certain days where it's not working and it's not meant to work.
And eventually I feel like I can get through it. I can get somewhere new.
Well, I get ideas from just everyday life, situations that occur to me.
It always starts as something personal.
And like in my life, if I'm like really stressed out and like feeling kind of angsty, I kind of channel that into something that I'm making, because I find that the end result is more, it's more real, and I think it's more powerful because it comes from a place of like truth.
How do I get my ideas? I guess just living, walking through my community.
They usually just come to me like randomly. This whole theme of cerebral clutter really goes well with me, I think.
My ideas usually come to me in solitude.
I do a lot of commercial art too, you know, so sometimes ideas have to be forced out of me.
One specific location I get a lot of ideas is the basketball court. I think the outdoor basketball courts of New York City are the perfect place for inspiration. When I think of an idea, I want to just be like, how can I put this into a hip-hop song or a play and get that idea across?
These are things that we all work from chaos. And what we try to do is put it all back together.
I will write everything I remember about that particular story, memory, what have you, and then I sort of pare it down into its essence.
A lot of times for me, it just comes as a big rush, and I just got to get it all down, because if I don't, it's hard to come back to it and find that same inspiration.
Maybe I communicate by, working to say what I'm trying to say.
It can take a little bit more work to figure out how to make it from your brain onto the screen.
Just developing it. I mean, a lot of times it'll start as like a really small idea.
Really, the work is about the work to me. So if I get an idea, I have to just do the work to work it out and express it.
I don't think my ideas have expiration dates.
No, there's no expiration date. Some of them just stick with you, some of them are with me, and some of them disappear, and you know, I don't know.
The ideas don't expire. They sometimes turn into something else.
The idea of love or the idea of tragedy has been survived since people were around.
If the mindset I had when I came up with that idea is the same, after too long, that idea will become stagnant.
I feel like if I come up with an idea and I don't immediately want to do it, I don't immediately say, like, I need to start working on this idea right now, then maybe it's not that great of an idea.
If I don't act on something within, like, when it's, like, fresh in my head, it'll kind of get pushed aside by the next random thing that attacks me.
I feel that although it doesn't have an expiration date, I have an expiration date, and my expiration date is sort of when I am able to pass it along to the teaching artists.
I just, ever since I can remember, music was this great three-dimensional thing for me.
I think I chose filmmaking because I had an amazing teacher.
It's more of like an addiction. You know? Yeah, I don't want to use like a drug metaphor, but that's really like the best. Yeah, that's really the best thing. I mean, it's like, the more you do it, the more you're addicted to it.
There is a property of painting that is really, that really gives you a pleasure. Gives me a pleasure, actually.
But the fact that mixed media can allow me to be a little more free in my interpretation of the world around me was really attractive to me.
When Arts for the People allows me to be creative 24/7, it allows me to constantly be thinking of new ideas, new programs, new workshops, new programs with interns.
Art just calms me down, just gives me peace.
I chose hip hop because, in my opinion, it is the largest community-oriented art form on the planet.
So somehow, maybe it chose me. I don't know.
A thousand times a tempted face, a thousand